Did I say everything I could say before you left? Did I do everything I could do for my friend? I call out your name, no one answers instead. I hear whispers.
I just got on from tour, saw some paper on my door. The note said, call John, when you get this, it's important. But I don't know no John, so I thought they was mistaken. Then I heard the phone ring as I dropped my suitcases. I picked it up, it was Head, he told me B is dead. The funeral's today, then he gave me the address. A chill went through my body, I had to catch my breath. He told me get cleaned up, he give me details when we met. Whatever that he said, after that I don't recall. Guess I must have just hung up the phone and floated down the hall. Pulled back the curtain, suddenly I felt exhausted. Tapped the water with my hand as it came out of the faucet. Pulled the curtain back, somehow climbed up in the shower. Then I leaned against the wall and cried for half an hour. Man, I'm crying now, just trying to get this written. And I want to hear his voice again, I only hear him whispering. Mother, father, brother, hella people I ain't seen. I sat next to Head, who was still in shock himself. We still ain't had a chance yet for him to tell me how. Then they brought his body out, completely wrapped in linen. That's when it finally hit me, my best friend's no longer living. My chest caved, I felt intense pain around my rib cage. My spirit gave when I saw his face. Tears shot like lightning when I saw it was official. My woman grabbed my hand, touched her lips against my temple. How does anybody deal with loss that sudden? This was harder than when I lost my father. At least with pops I saw coming. But no, sometimes death falls in our laps, and we don't have no control over how and when we pass. The imam said we won't spend the service mourning for him. Instead, whisper a prayer, remember the beautiful face he rose. Taught me how to stay out of trouble at a parallel bar. He kept me out the game, taught me how to roll up cannabis. His father loaned me books, his mother fixed me sandwiches. We even rapped together, he was OG Quannum, but we ain't finished together. That's where the tension started, I tried to do my best. Maybe that ain't how he felt about it. Although I know I gave her all, I still carry some guilt about it. There was tension, but over time it ain't affect our friendship. Still, if it was issues, he ain't never mentioned. He was always proud, maybe just a little stubborn. Many times I tried to reach, but he never told me nothing. Head had brought him home from a party in his yard. He started breathing heavy, head pulled over and he walked. He was kneeling on the curb, leaning up against the car. Then he whispered something and collapsed in Head's arms. Now here I am, scooping soil on his grave. Soon after that, his fam moved out to town, his little brother stayed. He lived with me for a while, since you weren't attending. He took your place as the best man in my wedding. He said some beautiful things in your honor, you'd be proud. He's soon to be a father with a family of his own now. I still feel you riding for me to this day. I say a little prayer, say what's up and whisper thanks.